accident.
An accident?
Of course. I did my very best to save her.
But Father told me...
The truth is, the ocean wasn't big enough for both your father and me.
So he sent me here. And now I see he's driven you away, too.
He doesn't understand me.
Oh, but I do, Duffy. We're so very alike, you and I. Gals with ambition.
Now tell me absolutely
everything.
I'm in love with someone. A human.
A prince, I hear. Quite a catch.
Well, the answer's simple. You've got to become human yourself.
Can you really do that?
My dear, sweet child. It's what I live for, to help unfortunate merfolk like yourself. Poor soul, with no one else to turn to.
I admit that in the past I've been a nasty. They weren't kidding when they called me a witch. But you'll find that nowadays I've mended all my ways. Repentance seems a lie to me, the switch.
True?
Yes. And I fortunately know a little magic. It's a talent that I always have possessed. And dear lady, please don't laugh. I've used it on behalf of the miserable, lonely, and depressed. Pathetic, poor, unfortunate soul. In pain, in need.
To be dinner.
That wants to get the dirt.
And do I help them?
Yes, indeed.
Those poor. Yes, I do. John, it's happened once or twice. Someone couldn't pay the price, and I'm afraid I had to rake them across the coals. Yes, I've had the odd complaint, but on the whole, I've been a saint to those poor, unfortunate souls. Now, I have a spell to turn you into a human for 3 days. Before the sun sets on the third day, begging dear old Quincy to kiss you. If you do, you'll stay human forever.
And if I don't?
You'll turn back into a mermaid and your soul will be mine forever.
Life's full of tough choices, isn't it?
Of course, there is one more thing. My feet.
But I don't have
any. Oh, I'm not asking much, only your voice.
But without my voice, how could I ever?
You have your looks. Your pretty face. Don't underestimate the importance.